Neptune had provided us a flat sea as we raced to rendezvous with the rising sun on the edge of Virginia's continental shelf. Little more than 2.5 hours had elapsed since Captain Steve Richardson eased the backlash from her slip at the Virginia Beach Fishing Center, setting a southeasterly course upon clearing the jetties of Rudy Inlet. I had been invited by 4 lovely ladies to spend the day pursuing the elusive blue marlin. Captain Steve made the baits ready with his own special brand of rigging. With the experience of a sport fishing career spanning nearly 4 decades, he knew all of the tricks. His record of successes with these majestic game fish is renowned in the world of sport fishing. He made one final inspection of the tackle. He wanted to be sure that all was just right for this particular day. There's nothing like being on location as the sun clears the horizon. Our mate, Steve Sadowski, blesses the baits as he places them over the side. Deidre Bell, the Virginia Beach and Tidewater regional editor for Sport Fishing Report magazine, was at the helm.
Deidre, you got us on location here, don't you?
I just follow the little green sign.
Steve getting the teasers out. The daisy chain there. How much water are we in?
100,000.
Right on the edge. And if we caught a bait moving to the top left of the screen there.
Cheryl McCleskey was getting herself fortified with a liquid breakfast. Lost in meditation, Heather Crowling appeared to be sending a telepathic message into the deep. Tabby Callow was worried the camera would capture her spirit.
The bridge down there below the surface. Is that all mullet, Steve, or?
The backlash blue angels were poised and ready.
I don't know how those marlin can resist that bait.
Out of water
for
the wrong rod,
about 400
pounds.
All right,
Cheryl. As the white marlin down the center came unglued, a big blue crashed the right rigger. Cheryl was in the chair, and the battle was on. Captain Steve sent a warning to the sport fisher off our stern to steer clear.
There he is over there.
There he is over there. Look at the size of that fish.
There you are. Woo-hoo! That teamwork down here looks like.
How much line's out?
You got much. You got maybe 100 feet, 150 feet.
Yay. All right, Cheryl. There you are,
Cheryl. Backlash.
That determination, look at determination there.
Nice and smooth on it.
Dwayne, she's doing a good job on this fish here. 80, what's he hooked on?
He's hooked on an 80-pound test leader and a 6-0 hook on a 30 with 30-pound string.
Well,
the way we did it, the red, white, and blue, though.
Yeah, well, that was a winning combination, so he settled in here a little bit.
Okay, get ready to start winding fast, Cheryl, because he's coming to the top. He's probably going to start jumping.
We can always hose her down with the wash down. Wayne, your bride's doing a good job here on this big old blue marlin. Teamwork, ain't it, Tabby? Captain Steve. Guided us to this blue marlin here. Got some whales coming up here to check us out. I hope he didn't call for reinforcements, Cheryl.
Back up.
Yeah, I hope he didn't call for reinforcements. Look at this. Wow. Heather, that's a good picture of you shimmering right there and those little stars dancing off the water. Look at Heather. She's a sweetheart. Captain Steve down there offering some words of encouragement. About an hour and 10 minutes into the fight here. A little massage here. It ain't cramping up, is it? My girl Tabby. Sure, you got a good fleet of trainers down there.
There he is, right there. I'm looking at the fish down there.
See him under the water right there, Bill?
Yeah.
A little over 2 hours into the fight.
Right there, I'm looking at the leader. Touch it?
Yep.
Got it? Okay. Now we put pressure on, did we make him come up here? Pretty work, Cheryl.
Thank you.
All right, congratulations.
Look at that
fish go. Gosh. All right, easy, right there. He is right there.
Damn, he's 500 pounds.
He's a nice fish. That's a nice. That was it.
That's 500 pounder.
You ready to get another one now? Congratulations. Cheryl, you deserve that beer after what, two hours and 15 minutes of fighting that fish.
You got that right. It really tastes good too.
Are you rested up now, ready to get a white? See, Heather's doing one of the things she does best. I just got one question for you. When you're out here on a yacht sport fishing, you've graduated to Heineken. In the bars, you're just doing that old Bud Light thing.
I get back and forth, but you know, they're domestic and not import.
Captain Steve, we can't complain now. You know, we got one nice blue marlin. And we saw three or four whites.
Four whites.
I'd say that's not a bad day at all.
Say
what that blue marlin did.
I'll raise the bars if you need them.
Look the girl good, it looks like. I like your mates though, Steve. I'll tell you, the cockpit on this boat looks a lot better than some of the other boats I've seen backing into the fishing center. Pretty day out here on the edge.
We enjoyed a comfortable return to Rudy Inlet, where the ceremonial release flag was hoisted from our rigger. An exuberant and proud Wayne McCleskey congratulated his victorious bride with a kiss as he helped her disembark the cockpit of Backlash.
Cheryl. Hey.
Cheryl, I'll call you later and I'll meet y'all over there at the Ducks of the Night.
Yeah, she should. We'll let you throw her in.
After the way I thought her whip that blue one, I don't want that part.
No more.
By the way, her arm and back's going to hurt later.
Did a good job, Cheryl.
Thank you, Backlash.
What a fabulous day it was for Deirdre, Heather, Tabby, and Cheryl. They had planned this high seas adventure for quite some time. I am honored that these ladies invited me to take part in their otherwise girls-only quest for that big blue marlin. From the moment of the strike, these Blue Angels worked together as a great team in bringing the blue to the transom of backlash. And it wouldn't have mattered which one of them was in the chair. The sheer brute strength of a 500-pound marlin, it seems, would overwhelm such a petite angler as Cheryl. But Cheryl's fierce determination, along with the concerted will of the others, and combined with the skills of our captain and mate, instead, was overwhelming to the blue. Cheryl reflected back on the day and the congratulations from her team, to which she was truly thankful. She knows that she could not have done it without them. Cheryl McCleskey is no stranger to the blue water, but somehow this was an extra special day. As she watched the release flag waving its salutes from the rigger, and upon seeing husband Wayne at the dock to welcome her home, she was just thankful for having been there. By the way, Cheryl, the rest of us are thankful for having been there with you.